S. Greg Zahler's follow-up to Brawl in Cell Block 99 has finally dropped. This time it stars Mel Gibson and Vince Vaughn. So let's talk about it. When two cops are suspended for excessive force, they decide to cross to the other side of the law. As a massive fan of both Bone Tomahawk and Brawl in Cell Block 99, I've been waiting for this movie for over a year. It was on my most anticipated list of last year. It just happened to come out last year, so finally I got to see it. Before I tell you what I thought about it, tell me what did you think about it down below in the comment section. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Are you somewhere in between? Did it live up to his previous films, or were you not even a fan of those ones in the first place? Let's have a nice lively discussion. With that said, let's get started talking about the good. And the best thing about this film is the director's storytelling. Certainly there are plenty of films out there that have similar premises and TV shows likewise, but nobody's making movies like this in the year 2019. And he's not playing by the current set of rules, whether you're talking about the pacing, the plot points you're supposed to hit. He's making the movie he wants to make that moves at the pace he wants it to move at. In fact, the way that he writes and directs films, it's almost like a novel because different sequences last much longer than they would normally last inside of a film, and you linger on a sequence as if it's a chapter inside of a book, and because of that, it makes certain plot points hit a little bit heavier than they might otherwise. There's a whole little element in the film about Jennifer Carpenter's character that could feel a little bit like this whole detour inside of the story, but when you understand the way he's telling his story, it makes certain characters have far more impact. Things matter so much more because of the way he tells this little side of the story to give a different perspective on the events that we're seeing. Likewise, because of the way he tells his stories in this chapter-like format, he creates these villains that are terrifying. We know very little about the villains inside of this film, except of how horrifying they are, how dangerous they are, and how unpredictable they are. And it's all because these little images that he tells us, and it goes back to the director's storytelling. His style might not be for everyone, but it is for me and it works, and I love what he's doing. And going back to what I said before about how no one is making movies like this anymore, basically the main plot of this movie doesn't kick in until about an hour into the film. And during that first hour, he's just setting up all the pieces, the little dominoes of the story. And you don't know that they're all dominoes in a nice little line that all fit together. But because he spends so much time setting everything up, once the story kicks in, you just see the dominoes get knocked over and the story play out. From there, you gotta talk about the cast, and Mel Gibson is perfectly cast as this aging, bitter, cynical cop who's not really fully crooked, even though he's doing some really bad and excessive things, and he's partnered wonderfully with Vince Vaughn. They have a really good dynamic on screen together, great chemistry. Each of them can play these characters that are doing things that you really don't like their actions, but you still kind of like them, and just, they're also both funny guys. The screenplay also has really nice dialogue inside of it, whether you're talking about the banter between the characters or the way he just inserts these very verbose characters into the mix. The dialogue pops and sticks out inside of the film. And it's one of the reasons that this film can be so slow-paced and be a slow burn is because you actually enjoy the dialogue and the interactions between the characters. Another nice thing inside the film is the use of sound. It's not like this big sound production type film, but at certain points, like little noises are turned way up in the mix, and so the right things crack, pop. There's a sequence where someone's eating a burger and you just, like, it's right there in your face, creating the right atmosphere that it's supposed to do. So there's a real nice use of sound here. And finally, the film does an excellent job of building this sense of tension, suspense, and dread inside of you. Because of that first hour of setup, we know where all these characters are at, how they're all moving towards one another as you go throughout the story. So once things start going, you just have this internal sense of dread because you know these different characters are eventually going to come to clash with one another, and you care about people on both sides of the equation because of that backstory that we got, and you just know, it's going to get very bad for everyone because we have information that the characters inside of the film don't have, and it just does a great job of running that out for the entire second half of the movie. About 90 minutes straight of the movie, you're just feeling the sense of tension, knowing awful things are coming. From there, let's move on to the mixed aspects of this film. And the two things that come to mind are that this movie is incredibly slow-paced and it's also very grim. For some people, that's what makes it so distinct and an interesting watch, because it's not in a hurry to tell its story. It's not trimming everything away. It's allowing its story to kind of like naturally unfold, and it takes a while to do that. Some people appreciate it, like me. Other people are just going to think it's boring. Because you can write down everything that happens in this movie, and it's a pretty short little list of things that happen, but the movie itself is 2.5 hours long because every sequence is so long. Even if it's just people driving down the road, it's a long sequence. And it's also a very grim film. There's not a lot of just great character, like nice characters inside of the film. Everyone is kind of morally ambiguous to awful, morally reprehensible, and there's a lot of graphic violence. Good guys get shot, bad guys get shot, good guys shoot other good guys. It's very intense and grim where this story goes, and it's gonna be too much for a lot of people. So it's not necessarily good or bad, but as things that are true about this film, that's what it's like. From there, let's move on to the negative. And the big thing that comes to mind is that there's some pretty big lapses in the logic of the film at certain points. Our lead characters are following another car, and they do some things that would draw obvious attention to them with no concern for getting noticed. There's some points in time where there's some car physics involving a car accident that didn't fully make sense. There's some points in time where people are incredibly accurate with pistols in tense situations that don't seem particularly believable. So there's a few of those moments sprinkled in the film. It's like, I think you could have done that thing right there a little bit better, because it pulled me out of the movie a little bit. And the other one that comes to mind is that because the film is so grim, there's not really anyone that you're rooting for. Naturally, we default to wanting our protagonists to win. There's a couple other characters we spend some time with that we want to see them successful. But at the end of the day, everyone's doing some pretty awful things. Everyone has done bad things inside of this film, and they are guilty of very bad things. And so it's difficult to fully root for anyone to succeed inside of a film where everyone is behaving so badly. But those are just a couple of minor squabbles. This is another triumphant slow burn from the director. Mel Gibson and Vince Vaughn are perfectly cast in this crime thriller. Overall, it's an 8-. It's an 8.5 on the entertainment scale, and I highly recommend you check it out if you're the right person. As of right now, I think this is my favorite movie of the year thus far. But tell me what you thought about it down below in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, and keep talking movies too much.